everyone, it's Warren from NQ Explorers. Today, Colleen and I and her brother Roy, today at the site of one of our favourite hunt sites that we return to annually when the sugarcane crop is cut. This is the site we call the Illegal Casino, and that's exactly what it was. It existed in the early 20th century, and it was a bit of a gambling den and a social club for the local cane cutters. Over the years, we found lots and lots of stuff in here, lots of silver coins. The copper slash bronze coins, they get pretty chewed up with the fertilizer in here, so they're not real good when they come out of the place, but there's plenty in here. This crop again has been cut and returned, so it's not been ploughed. So really we're detecting the same ground we did last year, but we'll have another crack at it, and then next year it'll be all turned over and all the treasure will come back to the surface. But we're going to spread out a bit further today than what we usually do. We've done a fairly small area in here, and there's an old Queenslander up the back that we visit occasionally. So we might do a bit in the front where the old casino was, and then back to the old farmhouse. It was a very old, big, classic Queenslander used to be there. I personally saw that thing in the late 1970s when it had collapsed, so I know where it was. But we'll concentrate in this area of the old casino for a few hours, and then we'll go down the back over there on the creek line where the old Queenslander house was. So thanks for viewing, and we'll be back shortly with our first relic. Okay, Roy's on the Ace 250. He's got the little sniper. He's got a nice coin bell tone here. We've only been here a couple of minutes, so he's had a bit of quick training on the machine and he's away already. He's got a good target here by the look of it, so we'll see what he comes up with. Won't be very, what was the depth indicator?
About
6. 6 inches?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Dig around it or you'll hit it. The thing is about the bronze coins, you know, the pennies are usually pretty chewed up with the fertiliser, the cactus, most of them, but if it's a silver coin, it'll be alright. We've found a lot of silver in here over the years. I'm going to check it again now with the machine and see if you're on the... I'm going to bring that prey pointer in. Get the prey pointer ready.
Oh yeah.
You're on it, you're on top of it, it's in the ground still. Colin's just going to check it with the pro pointer just to see exactly where it is.
64.
Oh yeah. Let's go wide so you, that's it. Hey,
there it is.
There it is, it's a penny, is it? It's got a halfpenny. Oh, it's an old bag. What a ripper.
Yeah,
it's
that
got
one.
Pin?
It's an old badge of some sort. Well, we'll clean her up and we'll have a look at it. That looks like a beauty. Might be an old CWA. Well, there's an old badge Roy just got. It's got a royal crown on the top and some sort of motif in the centre and some writing around the edge. It's got one pin. Must have been the rest of it's broken off, but that's a lovely find, that one. That's the first target of the day. So we've sort of moved a little bit further north of where we normally detect here, along a couple of rows up. So we'll persist in that area and see what comes in. Okay, we're on another dig here. Colleen's picked it up with the AT Pro, 75 target ID?
Yeah.
Oh, Roy got it, oh, you got it with the Ace first, okay. This is not, how far away from the badge? We're only a couple of metres from that badge. Like I said, we haven't really gone this far up along the rows. We've sort of concentrated in a very small area over the years. But since it hasn't been turned over this year, this field, we're going to go into some new areas and see what else. Because the plough, okay, the target's out. The plough spreads this stuff far and wide.
Get yours up there.
Check it with that little sniper.
Oh, there it is. I'll see what this
is. What is it?
Whatever it is.
Is that a grease nipple or something? Or a bike valve?
Hmm.
Well, this is where this AT Pro really shines. This penny I've just unearthed, you can see at the bottom of the hole, is a dead set 8 inches. It was just a whisper from the surface. The reason being I had probably about 4 inches of trash on top of that, so it was an amazing, it didn't really give much of a target ID, but it was a whisper of a signal. I dug right down here, the deeper I got, I thought, well, there's not much chance of this being a coin, but there you go. She's pretty chewed up, as they all are here. It looks like that's a Commonwealth penny. Very thin. All the fertiliser over 100 years is probably, it'll probably fall apart, this thing, but anyway, we'll have a look at it and get a date. Okay, there's that penny. It's a 1916 Commonwealth penny. You can see the edges are pretty chewed up. It's been in the ground for a long time, and it was very deep. It's either been ploughed down there or that's probably what's happened. It's been turned over the years, and it's got deeper into the soil. Plus, we're detecting sure as cane trash, so the AT Pro really punched down there. But like I said, you've got to listen for those little whispers, and often you won't even get a target ID, a digital target ID, until you get closer to the target. So that's how sensitive this double D coil is, and the soil's moist, so all the conditions are working in our favour today. This is a beautiful old coin. Colleen's over here on the AT Pro. She's just informed me she's got a buckle. She's sort of drifted a bit back towards where the old Queenslander used to be, behind the casino. Not really an area we've spent a lot of time in over the years, actually. What sort of buckle we got?
Is it a buckle? Actually, I wonder if it's like a catch off a suitcase or something.
Oh, no, that's
like that. A suitcase.
Looks like a little clip.
An ornate.
Is that dirt stuck in it? Or?
Yeah, there's still dirt on it.
No, it's a buckle. I think it's a buckle.
I'll have to clean it.
I'll go and soak that and clean it and see what it is. Looks. I don't really know. Appears to be like a lady's dress, a small buckle sort of thing.
Yeah.
Okay, no worries, good find. A nice high tone 76 here, fairly consistent. We'll have a crack at this one. Don't think it's going to be too deep. This area here is out near the road verge, so not ploughed so much as that spot where I just got that old 1960 penny right down deep. So the targets on this area may not be so deep. Early ground already. Still getting a 77, 78 there. That's all right. See what we got here. And a heap here. You end up with a probe on, really. Okay, so you end off a 303. Very rotted, and it's definitely a 303 shell. Colin's just exclaimed she's got an 8182 here on the AT Pro, up in the row, so this looks good. Possibly we missed this over the years, because if you come in here when the cane's higher, you can't get the coil up in these areas on top of the row. 8182. Is that it?
No.
Oh, that's a piece of a toy. Oh, it's plastic.
Yeah.
Still in the hole? Yeah, it's a good signal. Are you on? You're on standard mode, are you? Getting a bell tone there?
Yeah, standard.
What
is it? It's a coin.
A coin? Ripper. Let's have a look.
I saw something around. Maybe not.
I didn't spot it, but. Oh, yeah. It's up in the row there, which is. No. Which is a hand, which is hopeful, because it's up against the cane stool there, I think. Yeah, you haven't got it out yet.
No, I thought it.
Check it with the machine, eh? Well. Yeah, it's up in that cane stool. Some of the clods of dirt come out, they look like coins, they're round and shiny. You think you're going to have to open this hole up a bit?
Don't damage the thing.
No, that's the thing, we've got to make sure we don't damage the crop here. Oh, it might have moved, eh? Do you run into that cane still there?
On that side.
$81.82, this could be, well, a penny or silver or a big hunk of brass. Oh, it's right under the cane stool. See it?
No.
Okay, well, look, we'll continue with the digging. I'll come back shortly with what we find. Okay, here's Colleen's item that she dug. I'm not really sure what it is. I thought it was like a towel rail, but it's might be a ball joint or something off a tractor. I don't really know. We'll clean it up and have a look at it. This one's a high tone 82. got it out of the hole. It was very shallow, so I'm not confident it's going to be very old. I've got it here. Bit of tone roll now. I don't like the sound of that. I can see what it's a. Okay, what is this? Some sort of copper bobbin or something. Unknown purpose, possibly farm junk. Okay, Colin's made a nice find here. The Jeep, she reckons. Let me see. Oh, well, yeah, it is some sort of four-wheel drive. She's pretty. Oh, well, we'll be able to get a name off that and a brand. It looks like one of those old dinky toys with those red rims. Made in England, probably. That's a good find. What else did you find? A holy dollar. I hope so. Or is it a washer? I've seen your holy dollars in the past.
I can't find it now. What's that?
Copper pot, copper.
No,
okay, right. Nice. These finds aren't holy dollars. Is it silver?
Yeah, it was 82.
Righto, well, if it's a holy dollar, it's worth the suspense.
How big is it?
Well, it's pretty big.
As big as a penny.
It'll have 1813 or something stamped on it.
No, I can't find
okay,
it.
Okay, righto, it's
I
a dud.
It.
If we find the holy dollar, we'll be back. Okay, Roy's he's declaring he's just found a gold nugget. It does. I'm going to suggest it's lead, but okay. Looks like gold. We'll scratch it on a rock, and we'll probably be a bit of farm lead. But anyway, it looked good when it came out of the ground a bit. Oh, hang on a minute. Look at the silver. It's I don't know about your gold theory. What do you reckon?
Gold.
Yeah. Okay. Gold. Well, you got about 5 grams of gold there. If it's gold. My next target's none too exciting. It's an old toothpaste tube. Very high tone, of course, being aluminium. I've got something interesting here stuck in this soil ball. I thought it might be part of an old matchbox toy tractor or something, like the roof off a tractor. Looks to be an old toy part. Very high tone. And it's just been painted gold. I think it may be an old matchbox toy part. Okay, it's 2 weeks later. As you can see, the cane has grown substantially in that time. Absolutely glorious day today. Very hot and humid, but not a cloud in the sky. Might get a storm later in the afternoon. Anyway, I was just along the front here of the old casino, where we've been so many times, and I've just got another coin that we've missed on previous occasions. Here we go. Looks to me like that might be a 20 cent piece. It doesn't look to be big enough for a penny. It was only a 62 on the AT Pro. It could be a halfpenny. I'll give it a clean and we'll see what we got here.
76, but when I go this way, I can't get it at all.
Well, it's probably sitting on edge. Colleen's got a nice 75, 76 signal. She's in, as you can hear, she's getting a bell tone because she's in standard mode there on the AT Pro. Well, we'll have to see what we've got here. It wasn't very deep, eh? 3 or 4 inches there.
Oh, now it's back again.
Get an erratic signal in two directions, it might be a coin on edge. It's an old toothpaste tube. So this is a hot spot here. We're on the domestic area where the old house used to be. Good one. Colin just informs me she's got an 80 signal here. That's going to be potentially a good find. Still on the ground. You're still getting 80?
284.
So, as you can hear there, she's getting the coin bell tone in standard mode on the AT Pro. It's a rock, is it? It's a bit of quartz. It's a deep target.
Yeah, it is. It's 8 inches.
Okay. We'll be back with this shortly. We just dug a bucket load of toothpaste tubes all along this row of 7 or 8 of them. This is a 7980. As you can see, I've dug this area out. No bit of green glass there. I've got the target here. So, sounds pretty good for a 7980. Won't be a toothpaste tube, this one. Let's have a look. They were throwing... it's just a bit of copper pipe. Look, I guess I'm in the bathroom area. That's why I'm getting toothpaste tubes and bits of... Well, I just got a nice little piece of jewellery. It was a very scratchy signal, as you can imagine by the shape of the target and its conductivity as it presents to the coil. It's got a little attachment loop, some sort of necklace attachment, and it appears to be silver. Have a look at that. It's quite an old piece. I've just cleaned the back of it quickly. I'll just see if there's a hallmark on there, and I'll put any information on the video, but it's a strange looking little piece. I'm not quite sure what it is. When I clean it up, I'll have a good look, and I'll put some still photos up. Okay, Colin's cracked it. He's just got a coin, quite a shallow target. What you got? Ah.
It's 77, looks like a penny.
Crusty old penny, yeah. Oh, nice. You know what, this is, we've been up and down these rows so many times and the coins are still here. It just shows you can never really hunt a spot out.
We'll have to clean that one.
Yeah, I'll go and soak it and we'll get a date off it. Could be quite old. We get a lot of Commonwealth. We've even found old English Britannia pennies in here. Nice one. Colin's just called out. She's got another coin hot on the tail of that penny. She's just pinpointed it here. What is it? I think it could be a 1 cent piece, eh? Looks brown.
Is it?
We thought it might have been a threepence. Well, no, it's very, wait a minute, it might be. It's very thin and small. Well, it does look like it's got a brown edge, doesn't it? Anyway, it's definitely a coin. Look at the size of it, it's tiny. We'll give it a clean and we'll get some information. Well, Louis just called me over with a brilliant find here with his Ace 250. He's got a look at this, a lovely silver. Look at the condition of that thing. 1942D, is it, I think, sixpence? Beautiful condition. Right in the middle of the row, or just off the side, a couple inches down. Nice one. Colleen's called out, she's got a coin. She initially got a very high reading, 90 on it. She's hopeful this is big silver. Have a look at this. Yes, it looks like it's going to be a florin. That's the biggest piece of silver you're going to find here. That's a florin. What a find. Yep, you can see the milled edge on it. What a... Oh, brilliant. Yep, hey, that looks like that is an old florin. I think. I'm going to clean that now and we'll have a look at it. But what a great find. Well done. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay, we've just got another penny coming out of the ground here, and they're right in the middle of the row. They come out pretty crusty, the bronze coins here, but that one doesn't look too bad. And like I said earlier, some of them can be quite old here. They can be old Britannia pennies, so we'll clean it up and we'll have a good look at that one and get a year on. Well, it's a good solid 78 here, right in the middle of the row. It's a dead set 8 inches down above the below the trash level when you take that into account. And the soil's moist, that's where that AT Pro's punching so deep. Wow, that is thin, that one. Have a look at that thing. Oh, I don't know if I'm going to be able to get a date off it, but it's very thin. Right in the middle of the row. Nice one. Well, there's that penny, very crusty, corroded around the edges. It's recognisable as an Australian Commonwealth penny. King George the Sixth. King George the Fifth, beg your pardon. 19... Well... I can't quite make that out. It is... Oh, it's 19-teens. Must be another wartime penny, First World War penny by the look of it. It goes with that florin that Colleen found. So anyway, I'll subtitle that date. I can't make that out. It may be 1917. Well, we're going to wrap it up there. We've made some great finds there today. You can see Colin's still at it. I guess the premier find being that beautiful old Florin 1917 that Colin got. Sterling silver 925. We have found a few large silver coins in here over the years, so that's not really a surprise, but being a gambling den, you'd expect that. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed that video, everyone. Thanks for watching. Happy prospecting. Bye for now.